I love you, representing the spirit of purple.
Sister Lucy wishes you happy pride. Serenity, blue. Sister Glow here from the healing spirit of orange. Embrace true healing. Happy pride. The sisters decree that you celebrate your place in the rainbow of inclusion. Whichever color you are, let us celebrate and love one another and all. Happy Pride!
Hey, how you doing? You know, it's really funny because tonight, I'm going to show my age. Tonight, I feel like Martha Quinn. Crickets. Martha Quinn was one of the first female DJs on MTV, and that's what tonight's all about. We're going to go live, we're going to go video, and here I am, the MTV generation. I know, everybody's singing it. You know, I'm not auditioning for MTV.
Darling, what are you talking about?
I don't know. It's way over everybody's head.
Way over.
They're all too young because MTV now is all those dating shows and
well,
whatever.
I used to watch MTV.
Speaking of sexy dating shows, did you introduce Rico yet? Our virtual go-go boy?
Well, he was actually trying. I was going to give him a little donation, you see, because he was very generous earlier. So he's got a very generous jock strap here as well.
Oh, there you go.
Give
it up for Rico, our virtual. Virtual and safe distancing go-go boy, and he's for hire from Las Vegas Mannequin. And give it out for Cocky Funk for creating that incredible Rainbow Pride swimsuit. And it is a full swimsuit with a little zipper in the front for all your change or whatever you want to put up there. So you know what? This next performer, I love her dearly. I'm sad she's not here, but she has this huge dinner planned every year for her father for Father's Day. I'm going to this camera right here. And she forgot today was Father's Day. And she called me the other day and she goes, "It's Father's Day." And I was like, "You're excused." But I want to talk to you about her. And I have to have the notes because I don't have my glasses. Vida McQueen, her and I go way, way, way back. And if you don't know the name, you should know the name Vida. Vida is an Emmy Award winning performer, singer, and songwriter. You can give this girl like two notes. She would be good and name this tune. You can give her two notes of a song, and she can do a Broadway medley out of it. She is amazing. She is an instrumentalist, and she's nationally recognized a voiceover artist, which most people don't know. Voiceover artist is incredible. And she's now, well, when we open back up, she's part of Menopause the Musical. Vida, I love you so much for being a part of this. And this is a video from her composer showcase at the Smith Center. And please pay attention. This is one of the funniest songs I've heard ever. So, Vida, take it away.
A label's just a label, and a name is just a name. Some call me a broad, and to others, I'm a dame. However, a new moniker from gay men I've received to mark my queen bee status as something I've achieved. I'm a fag hag, and I'm a fruit fly. You can call me fairy princess if you like. Don't pigeonhole me until you know me. Besides the boys, all my other friends are dykes. Ain't got no straight friends. I love my gay men, and I love it when they dress me up in drag. If you need a good beard to hide that you're queer, just call on me, cause I'm the queen of hags. I've tried to join a bunco group and make some female friends, but they don't know Friend of Dorothy or who sang It's Raining Men. Thank you. They won't marathon the Golden Girls or sing old Broadway tunes and wouldn't dream of meeting up for drinks in the afternoon. I'm a queer dear, and I don't care. And if you have an issue, kiss my derriere. Let's drink to Sondheim or Diana Ross or do a Candor Ebbinelli marathon. Just call me Fagnet or a boy magnet, Fagatina or even Hagalong. If you want a best friend who just loves gay men, just call on me, cause I'm the queen of hags. No matter where I live, I always make tons of new friends. Coast to coast and town to town, I meet the hottest men. I can quote from Mommy Dearest to Wong Fu and Sordid Lives. But even Bette and Julie Newmar aren't a bit as big a hag as I. Truth. I'm a fag hag, even a drag hag, and the boys at Lucky Tang's know me by name. Whether a tranny, a twink, or bear, I've been appointed to the Gay Boys Hall of Fame. I bet you didn't even know there was one, did ya? Ah! I love my homos like Cher loved her Bono, and don't think I bloviate or mean to brag. Should have been a gay man without the spray tan, so let's have a drink, cause I'm the queen, I think. My friends are all queens, me, I am the queen of hags.
Vida McQueen, we should do an encore. We love you. Thank you so much. Give it up for Vida McQueen, everyone. Yes, in the house. Yes. Yes, I know you're all out there applauding. So our next performer, and I also go way back, Andrew Ryan and I have been friends for years here in Las Vegas. And he's performed on the Strip. He's performed across the country, nationally, everywhere. He's national acclaim as a Shania Twain impersonator, and just phenomenal. I think he looks better than Shania Twain now. Anyhow, but Andrew is a dear friend, and he's part of our network here in the community, and one heck of a performer. So please welcome live to our stage at the Space, Andrew Ryan.
Like show business, like no business I know. Everything about it is appealing, everything the traffic will allow. Nowhere could you get that happy feeling when you are stealing that extra bow. There's no people like show people. They smile when they are lost. Yesterday they told you you would not go far. That night you open, and there you are. Next day on your dressing room they've hung a star. Let's go on with the show. The costumes, the scenery, the makeup, the props, the audience that lifts you when you're down. The headaches, the heartaches, the backaches, the flops, the sheriff who escorts you out of town. The opening when your heart beats like a drum. The closing when the customers don't come.
There's no business like show business like no business I know.
Get word before the show has started that your favorite uncle died at dawn. And top of that, your pa and ma have parted. You're broken-hearted, but you go on.
There's no people like show. People, they smile when they are low.
Even with a turkey that you know has fold, you may be stranded out in the cold. Change it for a sack of gold. Let's go on with the show. Let's go on with the show.
What I am, I am my own special creation. So come take a look, give me the hook or the ovation. It's my world that I want to have a little pride in. My world, and it's not a place I have to hide in. Life's not worth a damn till you can say, Hey world, I am what I am. I am what I am. I don't want praise, I don't want pity. I bang my own drum. Some think it's noise, I think it's pretty. And so what if I love each feather and each spangle? Why not try to see things from a different angle? Your life is a sham till you can shout out loud, I am what I am. I am what I am, and what I am needs no excuses. I deal my own deck, sometimes the ace, sometimes the deuces. There's one life and there's no return and no deposit. One life, so it's time to open up your closet. Life's not worth a damn till you
bitch. Twice.
Here's a fan. So we're gonna let Andrew take his breath. Take a breath. We're gonna talk. No, okay, go get some water. He's coming right back. So little did I know, I love this because it's improv too and it's live. I don't know where I'm gonna look over there. I didn't know that when you hid behind the theater wing, you can see each other in your camera. So I'm not used to such a wide angle lens because I
was
need
hiding
that.
Behind Rico.
That's why Rico's smiling.
Yeah.
So let's
Rico's
give it up real
smiling because he donated, and I think after you've seen that, just by the way,
he did donate.
He donate. Yeah.
So that's one of our favorite numbers, and Andrew, thank you so much. He's coming back out.
I needed
but
that.
He's been all over the stage, and that gives us a good. It's a good segue for our sponsors, and a huge shout out to Las Vegas Mannequins for Rico, Balloons with a Twist. Beautiful decor, rainbow balloons with a twist. Huge shout out to Flex Cocktail Lounge for supplying the libations, the space, and also Q Life. There he is, Russ. Russ and Garrett's over there. We're doing that technical stuff.
No idea, darling. You know, clearly, I have no idea.
Me and I on the technical stuff. It's like I've plugged it in.
That's what I was doing behind
Rico. The red switch goes on. Andrew, come on up. Come on up.
Honey, that was amazing.
That was amazing. You
I really needed that.
Cut your breath. You stole my fan and you never brought it back. See how you are? Oh, you're good. You want to talk a little bit? Sure. Tell us. Just talk to us.
Well, hello. Hello, everybody. Thank you so much for joining us. We're over here. We're over there. I'm looking for the red light. I don't see it.
Got it.
So thank you all so much for having us. This is such an incredible lineup you've put together this evening. We are all so honored to be a part of it. And Misbehave, partner
in
crime.
This is my first time out. I've been in the house since March.
Since February, I think, was the last time I had makeup on in
Same
public.
Year.
No, but thank you so much. And I also wanted to just really quickly thank you both for all of the work that you guys have done.
This is all Norma.
Norma have hosted the Black and White Party several years each. And so we want to thank you guys so much from AFAN from the bottom of our hearts. And if you don't know AFAN, look it up, afanlv.org, Aid for AIDS of Nevada. I'm the marketing director and events director. We aren't having many events right now. However, we do have an art event coming up in August. So keep an eye out on that and stay tuned because we do have some great programming coming up that's all virtual and safe in the age of coronavirus. And our services are continuing. Yeah, coronavirus. Yeah, AFAN is still 100% delivering services to the HIV/AIDS community in Las Vegas. And the last thing that I wanted to say, just before I go, is that I wanted to dedicate that number to all of our transgender friends. We are your allies. We love you, and you are beautiful. Yeah. So thank you so much for letting me perform that for you.
Thank you for that.
Thank you, thank you.
That was so beautiful. Oh, darling, hang on. I've got you. One sec, one sec.
Oh, you got it. No, we're good. So all of you who don't know Auntie Norma, she can get crazy at times, but you know what? It's all about improv. We love doing this for you all.
It's also all about the money, darling, because I'm just the voice of doom here saying, look, the center is a wonderful... You don't have to do this, I'll do it.
No, you're good.
But the center is a wonderful thing, and if you've got fucking money, give it. If you haven't, happy
Can
pride.
I hold up one of your signs?
Yes, darling,
I love this.
You know, if you
She
have
spent
money,
a lot of money on these signs.
A lot
Look
of money.
This.
You know, you give what you can.
Text.
That's basically the thing. Be honest with yourself. You give what you can.
Donate. D-O-N-A-T. Donate. There you go. Donate. Donate.
Playing
text donate to
playing
that
at Charlie's
right
next week.
There you go. Donate. But it's very important. This community in Las Vegas has some powerful people. And the next powerful person who's going to send out a message, and I got to read this because I always mess it up, because it's a long title. But this individual, she's fat. She is fat, but it's a PH fat. And I love her dearly. She's a young pup. But she is our 22nd Empress of the Imperial Royal Sovereign Court of the Desert Empire. And I had to read it because it's so long. But Fat Patty is here tonight giving a shout out. And Patty, I love you. She was out last night, the first time social distancing for the charities that, and the center is one of those charities that the Royal Court support. They raised $1,500 last night in about 2 hours at a very safe social event. But Fat Patty, I love you. Let's hear what you have to say.
Hello and happy Pride. My name is Fat Patty and I am the reigning Empress of the Imperial Royal Sovereign Court of the Desert Empire Incorporated. Known here in Las Vegas as The Court, we've been around for 23 years and we have raised hundreds of thousands of dollars for local organizations all over Southern Nevada. This year, our beneficiaries are the LGBT Center of Southern Nevada, Nathan Adelson Hospice, the Sin City Sisters SADAP program, and a new organization that we are excited to partner with this year, the American Foundation of Suicide Prevention Nevada Chapter. You can see us all around town with our big sparkly crowns, just having fun and raising money. I just wanted to stop by and say happy Pride, everyone. And also, please be safe as our current climate is a little hectic with COVID-19 going on, amongst other things. But always remember, be who you are, be loud, and be proud. Bye.
Patty, I love Patty. I absolutely love Patty. One of the most genuine, and she also got a little hair in her chest like Auntie Norman. I love you. I'm getting emotional. Patty has the drive that a lot of people here in Las Vegas need to find at her age. And this next performer sent in a video, Kiska Diva. All I have to do is say the name Kiska. Kiska, I've known for years, and she's like you. You don't get emotional. Kiska is one of those individuals I won't see for a while, but then I pick up the phone or I text her and email her, and she'll be here for us. She's here for us via video, and this is one of those videos that was shot at her home that has so much power. And just watch her. She is a philanthropist. She's a community activist. She's an incredible activist. She's an incredible performer, and her lip sync is always on point. She's seen locally and nationally in theaters and clubs all around. Kiska Diva, I love you. Bring it, girl.
I'm trying to hold my breath, let it stay this way, can't let this moment end. You set off a dream, getting louder now, can you hear it echoing? My hand, will you share this with me? 'Cause darling, without you, shine a thousand spotlights. All stars we steal from the night sky will never be enough. Never be enough. Tell me, oh, still too little. These hands could hold the world, but it'll never be enough. Never be enough for me. Never, never. Never, never. Never for me. For me. Never enough. Never, never. Never enough. Never, never. Never enough. For me. For me. For me.
That's all I'm going to say. Kiska, God bless you. I'm speechless. And a powerful performance from the corner of her living room. If I would have done that in my living room, the lamps, the accessories, and the candles would all be on the floor. You know how clumsy
and
I am.
Bar, and the bar, dear.
But whew, whew, take a breath. True, this is me. Take me for what I am. This is me. That's what tonight's all about.
Exactly.
Proud,
exactly.
Proud together.
Yeah.
Proud together. Now, this next performer, another video live. I like. Look at that look. Look. Look how big her boobies look. Anyhow, oh, look. Oh, there he is.
I am stealing that dress.
Is that man standing behind me? Rico. Rico.
Excuse me?
Anyhow, this next performer, Chase Brown. Chase Brown hit national news. There you go. Hit national news because he got pulled over by the police when they shut down Las Vegas. He was putting on a concert in the back of his pickup truck. Amazing. Chase Brown is incredible, and he couldn't be here tonight. He goes, Norma, just pick whatever. Pick whatever. And he's known for, like, his Elvis songs, but I found one song that I absolutely love. And you know what? The man, he's not a troublemaker, but, yes, he did shut down the Las Vegas Strip with the police, but yet the police were dancing with him, which I thought was incredible. He is Chase in the Pursuit is his band. He's all around Las Vegas, but he's become such a friend and ally to the community. And this next song, I saw this song. I've seen this song twice, and I found the video, and I'm just going to leave it there. Chase Brown, ladies and gentlemen.
I'm a man who loves a man. It really doesn't matter if you understand. I won't hide what's really inside. I'm a man. It's time to kill my fears. Let them live for too many years. I won't be deprived. I can't live a lie. I'm a man who loves a man. Who loves a man. A chance on hesitating, no wasting time trying to decide who I am. No more silence, no more feeling ashamed, no more wondering if I'm okay. It's time to live out loud and be proud. I'm a man who loves a man.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chase Brown, he's going to shoot me because, well, the fans will shoot me because most of Chase Brown's videos and performances, he's shirtless. And if you've seen him perform live, there's nothing wrong with being shirtless if you're Chase Brown. But I found that song and I absolutely love that song. The next performer we have coming live is a good friend of mine. And we've recently reacquainted and life's like that sometimes. you're with somebody and you know someone and everybody takes a different path and then you join back together and I'm so glad we reconnected. Powerhouse, he's a powerhouse. Domo, that name, I love that name. I'm old Domo a lot though. You know, I'm old school. That's but you know what? Anyhow, a good friend, a huge community activist, and social activist, and his spoken word is why I wanted him here tonight, because tonight's all about proud and being together. Please welcome Domo.
Today, we celebrate years of pride, of standing tall, proud, side by side in the LGBT community, looking back on a rich history of being ourselves and fighting for equality. I wanted to stand in front of you tonight and perform for you an inspirational poem of joy, bonding together and remembrance of a proud, rich history. I wanted to recount with you the years of Stonewall and how far we've come to colorful parades miles long in downtown Las Vegas, a diversity of LGBT and allies filling the streets and showing the world with what it means to be here, queer, and not going anywhere. I wanted to leave you with the parting words of great inspiration in the form of quotes from previous poets, words that would fill your hearts with warm, fuzzy feelings to carry you throughout the rest of the evening. I wanted to write you something that would bring all of these elements out to fulfill the spirit of the occasion, but I found myself unable to do so authentically without acknowledging the reality of today. Now, don't worry. This is not a sermon or a guilt or even a rally cry to action that would disturb the comfortable on this joyous occasion of proudly standing together. This is not the time to educate others on how to be a better ally for your Black or trans or queer community, or how to become better listeners and believers of their stories, or how to even empower their stories by taking the challenge of educating yourselves on privilege, systemic racism, and true equality so that we can sit with our own discomfort and examine what they may be contributing to the problem and solution without deflecting to defensiveness or guilty. We're not even going to go and get into how the streets in the Bay Area are painted with Black Lives Matter in colorful, colorful words. Or we're not going to even get into how protests are bringing people together to call for justice on Tony McCade, Breonna Taylor, Ray Milton, Ahmaud Arbery, and George Floyd, and many others. We're not even going to get into how a breath of hope was shown when the Supreme Court backed us in protecting our rights of lives of LGBT workers. But instead, I offer you tonight conversations that I've had with my father, some inspirational summaries of lessons that I've interpreted from a man who believes in love, self-empowerment, and made-up wars he's never fought in, that he shared with his 36-year-old son that he didn't know he had until 5 years ago. Lesson one, don't take any wooden nickels. Don't allow yourself to fall for what looks and sounds good without doing your homework first. For all that say that they are looking out for you and have your back, there is one that may do you harm and swindle you out of your kindness, joy, love, and time. So always know what you stand for and what you believe at your core. The less wooden nickels you take, the more you will only accept the things that you are worthy of being. So remember, if you remember your center, your core, you won't accept anything less for who you are. Lesson two, it's not what they call you, but what you answer to. So make sure you only answer to what respectfully supports you as an existing human being. People will always talk about you behind your back and even passively in front of your face, but don't you answer to anything lesser than the king that you are. So next time you walk down the street, hold your head up high with pride, knowing that you are the descendant of royalty and nobility, and that royalty bows down to no one. We do not answer the call of men like swine and pigs because we carry with us the pride of our elders, our ancestors, who answered their call to who they are, sometimes with throwing bricks, sometimes with busing boycotts. But they were true to who they were inside. Lesson three. If you're old enough to join AARP, take the free backpack. It's not about being owed or given something, but about recognizing that none of us can do this alone. So be willing to ask for help and accept help with grace. We often carry so much weight and fear around needing help that we equate ourselves to becoming invincible or even invulnerable, unable to reach out when we are sinking in that quicksand. But no movement was ever carried alone and by themselves. Each act stemmed for a call for help, for others, for education, from support for friends, family, humanity. The larger the task, the deeper the oppression, the louder the voice of help and change begins to sing. So if someone asks for your help, hear them. If someone tells you their story, believe them. Listen without defense or judgment, but rather acknowledge the bravery it took to be willing to ask. Demand to be heard. Demand to be seen. Demand that they empathize with you. And when it is your turn to speak, get that free backpack. Do not hesitate to take what is rightfully yours. Lesson 4, always pay your debts. Where I stand today was not by my doing. It was by sacrifice of the giants that came before me. Strong wills that fought hard to not break, even when faced with threats from ranging from death or entire cultures being taken away. And until that debt is paid, until we the people really invokes equality for all, I will continue to strive for that right to be seen and accepted equally for who I am by taking every opportunity necessary. I will repay respect by showing it for myself and for others, by listening to others and their stories, celebrating our successes over sexual repression, unfair judgment, and overcoming the barriers that we built to keep us away from one another. I will repay my debt as I walk with honor. Remember at my core that I came from royalty, so I conduct myself as such, show the world that I am not theirs to overlook or ignore. I am a powerful force at my core. And the world will hear my voice and not keep me silenced. It will hear my brothers' voices, my sisters' voices, my voices of my non-binary family's voices, and they will hear us because we have fought to be heard. We are a continuation of everything that is good and right in this world. Not only are we owed the right to live, we will continue to demand that the world hear us through our protests, our words, our songs, that we are valid, and that our lives matter. And that you will not erase the hard work of our ancestors that gave us this opportunity today. Lesson 5, be a man. It was once said that the hardest thing one can do is to learn to be themselves in a world that is trying to get them to be everything but. So in that classic father to son hand-me-down, I encourage you to remember to be a man. Be the one that opens the door even when the person across from you is threatened by you. Be the man who's the first one to grab that box of tissues at the end of the Hallmark commercial when everyone else is just saying that they have something in their eye. Be the man that calls for his wife or his partner to ask for help so you can trap that spider because you're scared of getting it by yourself and you just want to take it outside because you want it to live. Be the man that sits strong in his tears, holding his loved ones close as you discuss what happens to you when you are picked up or jailed or killed or removed from this family for simply existing. Be the man that when your trans brothers and sisters, a gender nonconforming, genderqueer spirits of light, come against the darkness, that you stand with them, beside them, encouraging them to defeat the darkness with their own light. Be that man that lifts up others when they are doing well, when they are depressed, when they are plagued with self-consciousness, insecurity about a few extra pounds or lack of. You be that man that jogs, that sits with them and tells them that you are there for whatever they need so that they can be themselves, that you want to be with them so they don't change. Be that man who knows that law does not mean right, that morality is strengthened by community bonding, and that the greatest test of a man's strength is his ability to love and show love even when pushed down, spat upon, or hurt. Be the man that the universe created in you in human form to walk amongst this earth. Here's my last bonus lesson from me to you. Never stop dreaming. I dreamt of writing this great inspirational piece to perform tonight that highlights the joys of coming together. But alas, my dream right now is on hold. My heart is hurting My heart is broken. But I do offer you these words. What happens to a dream deferred? Does it dry up like a raisin in the sun? Or fester like a sore and run? Does it stink like rotten meat? Or crust in sugar over like syrupy sweet? Maybe it just sags a heavy load. Or does it explode?
Once again, thank you so much. Take a breath. Everybody take a breath. This is exactly why we have to social distance. But that's good. I want to hug you so much. This is exactly why this individual is so important to our community. Your spoken word is amazing. And that is handwritten. Handwritten. I don't know how you do it. Handwritten. So we're going to type that up. We have to share that. We have to share that. Thank you so much. Give it up for Domo and the spoken word. Wow. Wow. Take a breath. Take a breath. That's what it's all about. That's what this event's all about. So we went off stage because we can't hide behind the truss. Amy and I went off stage. And I hear we crashed a server. And I think that's kind of good. I don't know, but I think we crashed a server. We had so many people going to the center's website. Like at the beginning of this, we crashed a server. So I hope our insurance covers the crash. You know, call Geico, you know. But I hope. But anyhow, so that's what I'm going to tell them right now. So we crashed the server, which is good. Now we're back up and going. Facebook and what's that other one? YouTube? MeTube? YouTube. Yeah, I know, I'm just teasing. It's YouTube. But please, please send in your contributions if you want to. Please, please, please. My goal tonight was about $5,000, and we're not there yet. We're not there yet. But donate. Text.
Some of these bitches got money.
I know they do. I know they do. But they don't want us to know, because then you'd find
out. They don't need to know.
Then you'd find a husband.
We don't need to know.
Or a wife, or please, whatever you want to find. Anyhow, donate. Text donate to 702-605-7500. That's right. That's right. So without any further ado, we're gonna switch it up. He leaves me speechless all the time, all the time. But he made a very, very important thing.
That was powerful.
Very powerful. As a man, we are fathers, and today is Father's Day. So happy Father's Day. Happy Father's Day, dads out there around the world. Moving
actually,
on.
Actually, only in America.
Only in America,
yeah,
really?
Yeah, it's a different day.
Is that like
UK.
A Hallmark holiday?
It's different in the UK, different in Australia, different
what
in America.
What is it in the UK? Are you from Britain?
September 12th.
Are you from Britain?
I'm from Britain,
love. Talk with Scotland, man.
You know, the country that's even
country?
More buggered than yours.
Country? Oh, where am I accent now? Where am I from?
Well, I think you might be from Australia now.
No, no. Well, I put some things down under. Anyhow, please welcome
you.
A message from the Nevada Gay Rodeo Association.
Howdy from the Nevada Gay Rodeo Association. We're so excited to be here, and we're sending out our love to everyone tonight. Not only are we celebrating Pride Month here in Las Vegas, but we're also here tonight to show our love and support to our home, the LGBTQ Community Center of Southern Nevada.
In these crazy times, it's more important than ever to come together as a community. And what better reason to celebrate than during Pride Month? The Nevada Gay Rodeo Association raises money all year long to give back to the Southern Nevada community. Though 2020 has been challenging, we continue to raise money for our beneficiaries. Our beneficiaries for 2020-2021 are PFLAG, Wild at Heart Mustang Sanctuary, and the Sin City Sisters of Perpetual Indulgence SADAP program.
So come out and support us at our next NGRA car wash, which is at Quads on June 28th from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Thank you so much to our crazy Auntie Norma and the space for bringing the community together tonight to celebrate Pride and celebrate the center and all that they do for us. We hope to see you all soon.
I told those crazy kids, no plugs, but hey, they're having a car wash over at Quads. There might be half-naked boys washing your car. Who knew? Anyhow, I love my rodeo peeps. I love my rodeo peeps. What do they say? ride a cowboy, save a horse, something like that. I don't know. Anyhow, this next performer sent in a video, and he had so many. You see him out and around in Las Vegas. You've seen him on national television, world renowned, and I Googled a bunch of his stuff. Wizard of Awesome, and that is perfect to describe Doc Phineas. If you know Doc Phineas, he's the Wizard of Awesome. You see him out and about, and he's like this Victorian steampunk gentleman. His English is amazing. It's just absolutely amazing. Star TV and movie and stage. He is a true gentleman. And every time I saw Doc Phineas, it reminds me of Willy Wonka. And then he told me about this video. Roll tape. Wonka is one of my favorite movies. I should have known then. But I didn't. All right. Our next video comes out is a huge shout out from good friends of ours at Golden Rainbow. We're skipping that one. We're good? Mark and Cheryl are next. All right. We're moving. Okay. So here we go. We are bringing on a incredible team, and that's why it's live theater. We are bringing on an incredible team, actually, who are part of the space, who own the space. Mark Chinook and Cheryl Darrow, am I pronouncing that right? I love them, and that's how I became familiar with the space. I was in the right place at the wrong time or the right place at the right time. I walked into the center, and there Russ White was talking to Mark and said, "Hey, Norma can be part of Monday's Dark for the center, the Disney edition." So I said, "Sure." And it was amazing. And that's planted the seed of my love for the space in Monday's Dark. So speaking of, let's bring Cheryl out. She got an incredible video, another fun home video you're going to love. And you're all going to know the song. Sing along if you know the words.
Quarantine is going to be a little different this year, so I thought I'd sing a little song for you, and I hope you like it.
up for Mark and Cheryl. Yes, Mark's going to kill me. We showed that video, but he's so sexy on that little blanket. I love his little furry chest. That's why we love Mark here at the Space and Monday's Dark. Mark and Cheryl, thank you so much for allowing us into your home tonight. You guys are both incredible, huge advocates of our community. Thank you so much. Speaking of advocates for our community in the center, give it up for Golden Rainbow.
On behalf of Golden Rainbow, I would like to wish everyone at the center a very happy Pride Month.
The spirit of pride will prevail.
On behalf of everyone associated with Golden Rainbow, happy Pride Month.
Be proud of who you are.
We are proud together.
Wishing you and everybody at the center happy Pride Month.
A happy Pride Month.
Happy Pride Month, that's right. Our community here in Las Vegas has recently, our entertainment community has recently been shut down. Of course, because everybody knows. So I want to give a huge shout out to those individuals who are joining us here tonight, because people are just starting to sneak out. But Eduardo, I'm going to embarrass you before you perform. Eduardo, I love him dearly. I can call upon him, and he's always here for us. An amazing performer, and he sent me a bio that was 12 pages long. I'm not going to read it all because, you know what, that's for Cosmopolitan. Eduardo, amazing dancer, choreography, and what I love here, it says, a aerial fitness instructor. Can you instruct me? Okay, yeah, whatever. That's not going to happen.
Keep talking. But I just love
I know. Look
Eduardo.
At him. Look at beautiful. Him. Ladies and gentlemen, this is your eye candy for the night, besides what's his face over here.
Meh, whatever.
Yeah, meh.
Hello,
it's
Eduardo.
All yours. Give us some love, Eduardo.
Hot.
Stay there. Turn around. Just stay in the middle of the stage and pose.
Turn
in the middle.
Around.
In the
water.
Middle.
We need
go
water.
To the middle.
Hang on. I've got
Learn
water.
My choreography. There you go. Eduardo. Ladies and gentlemen, Eduardo.
Eduardo.
We just have to look closer.
Do you want some tequila in the water,
oh my
Eduardo?
God, that was fabulous.
It's got a bit of
How do you do
there?
That? Is there like is there like sticky
there
tape
well.
On the pole?
No.
Can I do that next? No, we don't have that insurance writer.
Gonna go and get Eduardo some
so,
water,
thank you
Norma.
So much.
I'll
thank
be back
so
in
much.
A minute.
He's crazy. I love him. And I you're like, oh, wait, where's your description? It's like 4 pages long. Pole and what's it called? Not a pole dancer, but a aerial performance artist. Give it up for Eduardo, huge activist in our community. Thank you so much. Look at that little cute little outfit. Little rainbows and clouds. You are completely covered. Thank you. Because my grandma in Magnolia, Ohio is watching. Oh, put it away. All right. So our next performer, I got to meet here at the space many moons ago. And we were doing this virtual thing, Giving Tuesday, with Q Life and Russ and Garrett, and we met again on the phone, on the camera, on the video, whatever it's called. But Vin A, I don't know what to say, but if you know Vin A, whoo, Google it, ladies and gentlemen, an incredible Las Vegas Strip performer. He's been here at the space. He's in our community. He's a community ally. He's extremely sexy. That's all I'm going to say. And he has a group, a band. Is it a group or a band? I don't know. What's the difference? It's a band. A group is like 3 people. A band is like more than 5. Well, that's an orchestra. No. Anyhow, the Bronx Wanderers. Google it. YouTube it. There's some incredible music. He's seen in clubs and music venues nationally and here in Vegas. And Vin A., thank you so much for agreeing. He was the first person I texted, or what did I texted.
SMS sometimes they call it.
Whatever it's called. Yeah. But
message.
Enjoy this. Just enjoy. Vin A.
Hi, everybody. This is Vin A. from the Bronx Wanderers. I am so happy to be here celebrating Pride Month. And I want to give a shout out to the LGBTQ Center of Southern Nevada. Thank you guys for inviting me. I know times have been insanely tough and heated and full of a lot, but the fact that we can come together as a community and move the ball forward in the right direction gives me hope, and I hope it gives all of you hope. So what more fun way to do that than to give you 25 versions of me singing a song a cappella? So I hope you enjoy this version of me doing Your Imagination by Brian Wilson. Isn't it so cool that I get to do all these interviews from my underwear? Another car running fast, another song on the beach. I take a trip through the baths when summer's way out of reach. Another walk in the park when I need something to do. And when I feel all alone, sometimes I think about you. Take my hand, smile and see. Don't understand. To look in your eyes and see what you feel. And then realize that nothing's for real. Cause you know it's just your imagination running wild. Imagination running wild. Another bucket of sand, another wave at the pier. I miss the way that I used to call the shots around. You know it would have been nice if I had something to do. I took a trip through the baths and got to spend it with you. Take my hand, smile and see. Don't understand. To look in your eyes and see what you feel. And then realize. Real, cause you know it's just your imagination running wild. Running. Your imagination running wild.
Wow.
What's your imagination doing, Norma?
Well, he said he's wearing his underwear. Vin A., thank you so much.
Is your imagination running wild in the underwear?
When he said he was in his underwear, my imagination's running wild. And, and now's the time, because I don't know what's happening next. There's a surprise next. Now's the time to text DONATE, D-O-N-A-T-E, DONATE to 702-605-7500. Keep those donations coming in. If we don't reach the goal, that's okay, because it's about being proud together and celebration tonight. Text DONATE. You're so good at this. You're like Vanna White. 702-605-7500. 702-605. And if you donate now, here's the challenge. If you donate now, $25 or more gets you a free ticket to Auntie Norma's. I don't know what's going to happen in December. We're going to call it the Jingle Jangle Jamboree or
I
Jubilee.
I thought you were going to say that you got Vinay's underwear.
I don't have his underwear. I should have his underwear.
But if you text DONATE and the amount is over $150, we'll get the underwear.
We'll try to get the underwear. Vinay,
unwashed.
I'm sorry. It was her idea.
Unwashed and
it's
uncut.
Her idea. Okay, so now we have a surprise. So please donate. It's for the center. And I know times are tough, but you know what? Times are always tough. And you know what? I can't wait for my surprise because Joyce said there's a surprise and I might get... Am I going to get all crazy? Okay, roll it.
Hey, LGBTQ, Las Vegas. Happy Pride. I want to wish everybody at the center a very happy Pride. Be safe and keep making a difference. I love you guys.
Oh, my God. Okay, so I'm
breathe and out and in.
If I was a lesbian, that would be the girl I'd go after. Dot Marie Jones, ladies and gentlemen. Dot Marie Jones. Mark and Cheryl, thank you for that shout out. She Emmy Award winning. And you know her from Glee, but Glee is just like the icing on her cake. There's so much more to her. And I ran into her. Actually, I did talk to her one day at Gay Days at Disneyland. She has no clue who I am. But anyhow, we spoke. I was like, hi, how are you? And she went that way. We spoke.
Technically a conversation.
Like, yeah,
though.
like when I met Stephen Eady.
BFFs.
I met Stephen Eady. We talked about, it was a week after Frank Sinatra died. That's my fame, whatever. Anyhow, moving on. Now I don't know where I'm at.
You're at the space, dude. Oh, it's Pride. Oh, you're in the middle of a show.
My boys. Auntie Norma loves her Bears. Here's a shout out from the Bears Las Vegas.
Yes.
Yummy. Look at all those bears. Right about now, we'd be eating together, meeting together, celebrating our differences, enjoying each other's company, fighting for what we believe in, doing the things that bears do best, and sometimes just going out and enjoying a movie together. That's what Bears Las Vegas is all about. Celebrating each other together, spending time with people that are important, doing things for our community, being silly, getting all dressed up with nowhere to go, relaxing at the end of a long week, celebrating together, being together, and helping support the causes that matter to us. We can't wait to be out there supporting each of you, and we can't wait to celebrate Pride Month with all of you. Bears Las Vegas is proud together.
Norma loves her bears. She's a bear. I love a bear.
I've been around your pool when there are quite a few
bears. You know more about Auntie Norma than some people do, so don't make me misbehave.
I wouldn't dream
Lady
of it.
Lady B. Anyhow, send your donations in. Donate 702-605-7500. So this next individual is part of the Global Bears, and he's been here at the space, and he's incredible. He made this fun little video that we can all sing along to. I want everybody to sing along, get up, shake your hands, sing along to the song. Tom Goss, he's been to the house. We've had cocktails. He's an incredible individual. He is an American singer-songwriter, and he's young. He's a young, good-looking boy. But he's produced multiple albums. You can find them on whatever they find things streaming now.
Google it.
He's incredible. He's actually been on MTV, Logo, VH1. He's a dear friend of mine, and he's here for our Las Vegas community. So, Tom, I think we want to hear your video.
When life's got me feeling so down, I've got a quick trick to turn it around. I call my friends deep in in the 100-acre wood where Christopher Robin played. You'll find the enchanted neighborhood of Christopher's childhood days. A donkey named Eeyore is his friend, and Kanga and Little Roo. There's Rabbit and Piglet, and there's Owl, but most of all, Winnie the Pooh. Winnie the Pooh, Winnie the Pooh, a tubby little cubby all stuffed with fluff. He's Winnie the Pooh, Winnie the Pooh, a willy-nilly silly old bear. Sing it with me! Winnie the Pooh, Winnie the Pooh, a tubby little cubby all stuffed with fluff. He's Winnie the Pooh, Winnie the Pooh, a silly nilly willy old da da ba ba doo ba 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 da ba doo ba da ba ba da ba da. We'll be there with a wink and a smile and a great old time. Yeah, we'll be there wherever we are. There's some fun to be found. We'll be there when we turn that corner. We jump out the bush with the big bear hug and a smile. We'll be dashing and daring, courageous and caring, faithful and friendly with stories to share. All through the forest they sing out in chorus, marching along as their song fills the air. Gummy bears bouncing here and there and everywhere, adventure that's beyond compare. They are the gummy. Yogi Bear is smarter than the average bear. Yogi Bear is always in the ranger's hair. At a picnic table you will find him there, stuffing down more goodies than the average bear. He will sleep till noon, but before it's dark, he'll have every picnic basket that's in Jellystone Park. Yogi has it better than a millionaire. That's because he's smarter than the average bear. So anytime that life's too much to bear, just think of all our friendly, cuddly, lovely, happy, chubby bears.
Winnie the Pooh. I love that. Tom, thank you so much. So this is just hot off the teletype, and I love saying that because I don't know what a teletype is, but it sounds really good. So we had like 20,000 viewers on Facebook. 20,000 viewers!
Get you, girl.
Thank you. So, but remember, 20,000 viewers. If each one of you would go right now and donate a dollar.
A dollar.
A dollar.
50 cents.
A dollar.
A dollar.
A dollar. Because $5, $10.
Screw it. Like some 25 cents, some $5, it'll pan out.
But if each of you, 20,000 viewers on Facebook, that's crazy. That's great. I can't understand that technology. But if you donate a dollar, that'd be $20,000 to our community center. Girl, you got it. Donate 702-605-7500. And tonight, if you donate $1,500 or more, Miss B is going to come and act like a cougar at
I'll
your
come
house.
And dig deep, baby.
She'll dig deep. She'll dig deep. That's amazing. And
I got real nails.
We crashed things, and I don't understand this, but I love this. I feel like Rosie from the Jetsons. Like, I do not understand. Anyhow, we're moving right along because we're going on an hour. We're going hour and a half.
We're
going to do it quickly.
Minutes.
So my dear friend Chris Reynolds, I love him. Talk about an activist. Chris, I want to hear your voice.
Hello, everyone. I'm Chris Reynolds with ASP Care Specialty Pharmacy, but I'm also here tonight as the Executive Director of the Southern Nevada Health Consortium. Along with board members Chris Mendoza, Yendi Webster, and Rosita Castillo, we want to wish everyone a very happy Pride Month. The Center has been a great partner and member of the consortium for the last 10-plus years. They are an incredible leader in Las Vegas, providing many needed services to the Southern Nevada LGBTQ community. They are the home that many of us need. So tonight, let's celebrate that pride with the Center. A special thank you to Auntie Norma, The Space, for having the event tonight. So let's stand side by side with the Center and show everyone that we can be proud together. Thanks and have fun.
We're having fun. Are we having fun, Miss B?
We're having
this
fun.
This is when I was, I'm still flabbergasted, 20,000. I can't fathom that. A dollar. $20,000 for the Center, because you're watching us be fun and have fun tonight. And you know what? We're being proud together.
We are.
So this next group who sent a video, and I wanted them so much, and I've been talking to them for about a year, and hopefully they'll be at Auntie Norma's Jingle Bell Jubilee or whatever we're going to call it at the center in December. But the Las Vegas Men's Chorus, and just because it says men's, anybody can be in the chorus. The Las Vegas Men's Chorus is an incredible ally to our community, and I know so many of them, and their talents are through the roof. So here's a wonderful message from the Las Vegas Men's Chorus.
Happy Pride. The Las Vegas Men's Chorus is happy to be a part of this community, especially now. Times like these, we are reminded that our voices, though sometimes stifled, are powerful tools. Last year, we started rehearsing at the center, and our chorus flourished. We doubled in size and grew even stronger on stage. Without the center, we would be in a much different place. This year, we come together in spirit, with harmonies that come from our soul to remind everyone of the joy of singing. Las Vegas Men's Chorus stands as community, as allies, proud of who we are, and we stand together as Las Vegas. Happy Pride, y'all.
The Las Vegas Chorus. Amazing. And if you see their concerts advertised, please go. It's an amazing group. They're all volunteers, an amazing group, so talented. So we've come to the closing. And I don't want to say we've saved the best for last, but we have. We've saved the best for last. And we were talking backstage, and if he wasn't married and I wasn't married, Auntie Norma would be chasing him down Las Vegas Boulevard going, come here, baby. So I don't know what to say. Jason Allen, we met, I don't know if you remember, I was wearing that big Ursula costume, and I was like knocking everything over backstage, and I was like, ooh, look at that man. He's sexy. He is an entertainer, producer, performer, and a hell of a good singer. He is hot and handsome. He is if rhythm and blues and Broadway had a baby. How's that? How's that? You like that? You like that? I did. I kind of pulled it off your website. You'll pay me $10 later. He can be seen locally and nationally on stage and performing his many one-man shows and concerts. I don't know what else to say, but he's got a powerful performance. And we're going to end it here. I'm going to say goodbye when he's done. But tonight, it's Proud Together. I told myself I was not going to get emotional, but I'm doing it. I'm going to preach. Our times are tough. Our times are real tough. Everybody has a story. Everybody has an opinion. Two things we can do with that. Share your voice of love and concern, and share your vote. Jason Allen.
Call me later. I'm so glad to be here. Tonight, this is my home. If you don't know, this space is my home, and we couldn't be prouder to be hosting this amazing event for Proud Together, raising money for the center, LGBTQ center. It's a must. It's so important. The song that I chose tonight is from an amazing artist, an artist who left us far too soon, and a gay artist at that, but he wasn't. When I knew him, because in 1990, when I was a high school senior, so you can do the math, I'm not ashamed. In 1990, George Michael, with a group called Wham, hit the scene and was just amazing before 1990, but that's when I really remember him with Wham and such big hits. And in 1990, when he went solo in 89 and then in 90, he released an album that, you know, we weren't ready. You know, the world, they say, wasn't ready for people to come out, especially in the entertainment world. And he knew that. But he knew that he had to be true to himself. So if he couldn't come out, as they say, he decided to write a song that was so incredible that literally tells you, hey, I'm gay. And I don't mean to be a poet, but It's Okay. And I'm going to sing that song for you tonight because I didn't realize when I was in 1990, 18-year-old, what this song said. I wish I would have had the insight, because now in 2020, I see 15, 13, 12-year-olds. They know who they are, and they're proud of who they are, and I salute you. I marvel, and I'm so grateful to see you. But in 1990, George Michael released a song called Freedom 90. Now, I know you're at home or watching on your computers, wherever you are, your phone, but I want you to put your hands together. Come on. I won't let you down. I will not give you up. Gotta have some faith in my sound. It's the one good thing that I got. I won't let you down. So please don't give me up. Cause I would really, really love to stick around. Oh, yeah. Come on. Come on. It feels good. Well, heaven knows that I'm just a young boy. Didn't know what I wanted to be. We're every little hungry schoolgirl proud of joy. And I guess that was enough for me. To win the race, a prettier face, brand new clothes, and a big fat place on rock and roll TV. But to say the way I play the game is not the same, no way. See, I gotta make myself happy. I think there's something you should know. I think it's time I tell you so. There's something deep inside of me. There's someone I just gotta be. Take back your picture in a frame. Take back your singing in the rain. I just hope you understand. Sometimes the clothes do not make the man. All we have to do now is take these lies and make sound is the one good thing that I got. I won't let you down, so please don't give me up. Cause I would really, really love to stick around. Heaven knows we sure have some fun, boy. What a kick, just my buddy and me. We had every picture, good time band on the run, boy. And living in a fantasy. We won the race, got out of the place. I went back home, got a brand new face for the boys in MTV. But today, the way I play the game has got to change, oh yeah. See, I wanna make myself happy. Let me tell you something. I think there's something you should know. I think it's time we stop the show. There's something deep inside of me. There's someone I just gotta be. Take back your picture in the frame. Take back your singing in the rain. I just hope you understand. Sometimes the clothes do not make the man. All we have to do now is take these lies and make somehow. All we have to see is that I don't belong to you and you don't belong to me. Yeah, yeah, freedom. I won't let you down. I will not give you up. Gotta have some faith in myself. It's the one good thing that I got. I won't let you down. So please don't give me up. Cause I come on. see, I didn't understand. In 1990, living in Nebraska, y'all, that there were options for me. But in 2020, we know a lot better. Listen. See, it feels like the road to heaven, but it looks like the road to hell. Well, I knew inside my bread was butter. I took a knife as well. Hoping for another picture. Everyone's got to sell. But when you shake your ass, they notice fast. Some mistakes were built to last. Cause that's what you get. That's what you get. Say that's what you get for changing your mind. That's what you get. That's what you get after all this time. I just hope you understand. Sometimes the clothes do not make the man. Take these lies and make them true somehow. All we got to see is that I don't belong to you. And you don't belong. Love you, Ross.
Yes. Diva Distance.
Thank you.
Diva Distance. Wait. One more. Come here, boy. Honey.
Chuck, you know I was looking for the fan.
Sexy man.
I try to wear my Sophia shirt. Savage.
You did it. Savage. Thank you so much.
I love you guys.
What a
congratulations.
Way to end the show. Proud together. We're all proud together. Social distancing. Of course.
Socially. Distancing.
Socially.
But we can still wonder twin powers, baby.
That's right.
Activate.
That's right. Activate.
Uh-oh.
I have the Andorra power. Remember
I like
Andorra?
That.
Remember Andorra?
Of course I know Andorra.
Andorra. People like,
I named my cousin Andorra.
Oh, there. I love that.
Andorra Shandora.
Thank you so much.
God bless you. Thank you, guys.
We're going crazy
Thank you.
Tonight. We have crashed whatever it's called. We crashed something. We
the
crashed
internet.
The server.
The internet. If you broke did, the internet.
The internet server.
You
We've crashed. We've had 20,000 plus on Facebook. Wow. But we still need your donations. And like I said, it's not a fundraiser, but it is. The center is here. We are proud together. Text, donate, 702-605-7500. Miss B, thank you so much. We're 6 minutes over, but you know what? That's okay because we had Dot Marie Jones, Emmy Award winner. We had Grammy Award winners.
The whole show, Norma, was stunning.
Wow. Take a deep breath. Kids, thank you. Joy, Mark, the rest of you out here in this total darkness, but I love you all. All the performers who came, it's all about us, about being us. Last message, be true to yourself because you're the one who has to answer to yourself. Be part of love. That's all I'm going to say. We love you. Good night.
Happy Pride.
Happy Pride. Woo! And that's a wrap.